Welcome to this video walkthrough of the core data section of an entity registration in SAM.gov for non-federal entities. We showed you in our first video how to get a unique entity ID without completing a registration. If you have not watched that yet, we suggest that you start there. If you have already received your unique entity ID and you want to register your entity, sign into SAM.gov and go to your workspace, find the Entities widget, and select its title. Find the entity that you want to register, select the three dots near the expiration date, and then select Register from the menu. The next screen lets you know we have a couple of questions to ask you and also gives you the option to download a registration checklist. You will answer two questions about your goal and who asked you to come to SAM.gov. This page is a chart that compares all the registration options side by side. Confirm your purpose of registration on the next page. Review what entity information you will be required to provide in order to register. Say whether you are an employee or an officer of the entity, and then certify that you are allowed to update the entity. Next, the Continue Registration page displays. It shows the sections of the registration that you must complete based on your purpose of registration. Select Continue. Next, the Business Information page displays. Complete all sections designated with an asterisk. The first section, Your Entity's Business Information, asks you for your entity's start date and fiscal year end close date. The fiscal year end close date refers to the completion of a one-year accounting period. If your entity's fiscal year is the same as the calendar year, then your fiscal year ends on December 31st. In the physical address section, your address will be pre-populated. Please confirm its accuracy. Fill in the mailing address section. You can copy your physical address if they are the same. Once you have entered and verified your business information, select Save and Continue. Next, the IRS consent page displays. Be sure to check the page description at the top because it has important information. Read the Consent to Disclosure of Tax Information section carefully. Enter all mandatory data and the optional fields that apply to you or to your entity. Your taxpayer name may be different from your entity's legal business name. Enter the taxpayer name that the IRS has on file for your entity's taxpayer identification number, or TIN. You can find the name on your most recent tax return. Your TIN is either your employer identification number, EIN, or your Social Security number, if you are a sole proprietor who has not gotten an EIN. When you have finished, select Save and Continue. Next, the General Information page displays. This page asks for the general information about your entity, such as your country of incorporation, entity type, institution type, organization factors, entity structure, profit structure, socioeconomic factors, and other information. Use the drop-down menu and select the boxes to make your choices, then select Save and Continue. Next, the Financial Information page displays. Enter the financial information for your entity. This information will be used to pay you if you receive a federal award. First, answer the yes or no question, do you accept credit cards as a method of payment? It is easy to miss this required question. Complete the mandatory fields in the Electronic Funds Transfer, EFT, Automated Clearinghouse, ACH, and Remittance Address sections. Select Save and Continue when you have finished. Next, the system displays the executive compensation questions. Your answers will be available on usaspending.gov in association with any eligible federal award your entity receives. Respond to the executive compensation questions, and when you are finished, select Save and Continue. Next, the Proceedings Question page displays. Review the page description and then answer the proceedings questions for your entity. Once you have responded, select Save and Continue. Finally, you will reach the Review Core Data page. Review the information that you have entered. If you need to modify anything, select the Edit button in the upper right corner of the section you need to change. Once you are sure all sections are accurate, select Save and Continue. If you are registering to bid on contracts, that section will be Assertions. If you are only registering to bid on federal grants and loans, the Financial Assistance Representations and Certifications are next. Congratulations on finishing entering the Core Data section of your entity registration. Thank you for joining us for another video.